When mummifying their kings and queens, ancient Egyptians would remove the brain and all the internal organs except for one, the heart. Believing it held all thought and feeling, the deceased would need it in the afterlife when they rose again. By 2000 BC, Chinese doctors had uncovered the heart's role in pumping blood throughout the body, while Western thinkers from Aristotle to the Renaissance believed that the heart governed the emotions, a notion so powerful that it still persists today in a different form. The heart's symbol's resemblance to the real thing is debatable. Its origins are uncertain, but we see it as far back as the 6th century BC. Coins from Cyrene in what is now Libya carry the familiar emblem, representing silphium, a now extinct plant used as a cooking spice, perfume, aphrodisiac, and contraceptive. In the 17th century, St. Mary Margaret Alacoque reported seeing a vision of the Sacred Heart of Jesus surrounded by thorns. And the symbol has been associated with love and devotion ever since. Today, we know that love, along with all of our thoughts, desires, and emotions, comes from our brain, not our chest.
Where is fancy bread? In the heart or in the head? Shall we roll on?
I guess most people don't find it that romantic when you say, "I love you with all my limbic system." But even though love lives among our neurons, we can feel it here in a very real way. Physical pain activates the same regions of our brain as emotional loss. That neurological stress can overstimulate the body's vagus nerve, causing nausea, dizziness, and physical pain. Real, actual heartbreak. It's not all bad. When we see a loved one, our brain stimulates the release of epinephrine and norepinephrine from our adrenal glands, causing our heart to beat faster. But yes, one can desire too much of a good thing. Heart rates of 200 to 250 beats per minute could kill you or me, but to a pygmy shrew, that would feel tame. This thumbnail-sized relative of the mole has a resting heart rate of 1,300 beats per minute, about this fast. That even beats a hummingbird's hyperactive heart, and it's more than 15 times the average human's. A pygmy shrew will live just a year and a half, but in that time, their heart will beat about a billion times. An elephant? About a billion beats. A rabbit? About a billion. In fact, animals of all sizes seem to get about a billion heartbeats in a lifetime. The heart isn't some sort of ticking clock that counts down to 6 feet under, but there is some truth to the billion beat hypothesis. Because they have a larger ratio of surface area to mass, small animals lose heat more quickly than larger animals. So they have higher metabolic rates and their cells wear out more quickly. Scientists think that lower metabolic rates are directly linked with longer lifespans. As mass goes up, heart rates scale to the -1/4 power. So a cat is about 100 times more massive than a mouse, and its heart beats about 1/3 as fast. It works for lifespan too, only larger mass scales to the +1/4 power. That cat, 100 times larger than the mouse, lives about 3 times as long. Biologists call this the quarter power scaling principle. For different sized animals, measures of metabolism scale in multiples of 1/4. Except for us, we seem to be an outlier. Following that rule of size, we live about 3 times as long as we should and get about twice as many heartbeats as you'd expect. The advancements of modern science and medicine have extended our lifespans. Caring for one another helps us live longer. That's a lovely thought. Stay curious.